Well, I tuned in when I heard genitals, and then
It's about the
that's
drums,
so
boys. Come
insane.
on.
All you have is genitals in your mind now, huh?
Just very tasteful, just enough.
Yep.
So we're gonna
Sweet.
check L.S. DePatio out today. And what's his real name, though? I did look it up.
George.
George.
Is it George or Jorge?
He's from Spain, so probably Jorge.
Okay. It's like, I doubt it's George. I'm just saying. Wave is gonna help us try to understand this man. I don't know if that's gonna help anyways, because I'm sure Wave is also confused sometimes when he
Yeah,
plays.
me.
Your hard rock drums is definitely your thing, and you could tell you have a beautiful feel to your playing, and I
Oh,
absolutely
thank
love
you.
it. So, have you heard the song Godzilla by Eminem, Wave?
No.
Do you like Eminem?
I mean, I think he's a brilliant rapper from what I have heard.
I think you will enjoy this one. I think the rapping is phenomenal in this. Could be biased, though. I absolutely like Eminem. All right, let's check this out. Eminem,
Feel like
Godzilla.
Godzilla. Better hit the deck like Godzilla. My whole squad's in here walking around the party, a cross between a zombie.
Okay, first off, out the gate, I just love the fact that there's real drums on this, and it to me sounds cooler than just having a beat. Drummers like this are so good and so technical and so precise that some people are like,
"Dude, there's no feel. You sound like a machine."
But he obviously is not a machine, and I do feel the nuances and the vibe in his playing, which I think it lends itself really well to rap. When you have like a rap song like this, I would actually appreciate the hell out of it if rappers grabbed a drummer like him and just put that on their track instead. That'd be pretty badass.
Yeah, I
Yeah.
think all pop
It's like
music in
what
general, dude.
Yeah.
adding like sick drums to pop songs and making them actually fun to listen to.
Insomnia, ADHD, hydroxycut.
So something that I noticed when I pulled this from our live stream, by the way, we go to live every Sunday at 2 p.m. Mountain Standard Time right here on YouTube, is that when he was playing the drums right here at this particular moment, he pulls out the stick and he's using the shaker that's on top of the tom and he's making that noise. I thought that was really cool, and I didn't even realize he was doing that until I was watching this back. I'm like, oh crap, he's doing it the entire time. I just love how he comes up with different ways to make sounds, and that's really badass. I also love the miking of the drums too. The way he captures his drum sound is also really, really good. Not just his technique and his playing, he knows his way around the audio engineering, I would say, when it comes to capturing his drums, which is badass.
I love how he accents, like he's accenting the bass line with his tom, making it really pop, and then accenting some of the rap lines in his fills and stuff.
Yeah,
Sounds
like he's
so
using
cool.
the same cadence as the rap in his
Yeah.
drumming. Yeah.
I can do that with two hands.
Which part?
The hi-hat part. I can do that with two hands.
The hi-hat. Just the hi-hat.
I can do that and hit the snare. I'd just be lacking the tom, you know?
If this exact drum playing was in the song itself, would it be overkill for you guys?
It didn't seem like overkill at first, but some parts of it do seem like overkill.
I think it's cool because it's a drum cover and it's specifically drum centered for his content, right? But if this was in the actual song, it would be way overkill.
Yeah, and the radio wouldn't play it.
Boomer mode on.
The drums would distract way too much from the actual rapping.
This music is too interesting. We can't play this. It is perfectly tailored for his content. If it was a full band, a lot of people would be like, he's overplaying it, you know?
Yep.
Why do you think drummers are scared to do that kind of drumming anymore in music? We don't hear anybody just leaving space for the drums to complete the riff, if that makes sense.
Huh.
You know?
That's a good question. Lack of planning or lack of writing songs in the same room together, maybe?
Yeah.
Because, like, you can do that call and response thing when you're writing songs with your band. Like, hey, could you leave a space for me to do a fill here? But if one person writes a song and then the other person layers their parts in, maybe they're not thinking the same way. Like, we should do a call and response here, you know?
That's a good point.
They're just layering stuff. I stay exempt. How can I have all these fans that perspire like a liar's pants? I'm on fire and I got no plans to retire. And I'm still the man you admire. These chicks are spaz and I only get more handsome and flyer. I got this part's so cool right here. When you handsome on flyer. What goes around comes around just like the blades on the chainsaw. Cause I caught the flag, but my dollar stacked right off the bat like a baseball. See, I don't think this is overkill right here. This would fit perfectly. You just bring it down in the mix, right? He's putting it louder so we can all hear it. But that part, I think, complements the song so well, in my opinion. Yeah, it does. Just very tasteful, just enough. Bitch, I'm a player. I'm too motherfucking stingy for share. Won't even lend you an ear. Ain't even pretending to care. But I tell a bitch I'm Mary of Shabaria. Face of my genital area. The original Richard Ramirez. Christian Rivera. Cause my lyrics never sit well. So they want to give me the chance. Like a paraplegic. And it's scary calling Harry Carey. Cause every time I'm digging hair. What? Is Richard Ramirez referencing the Night Stalker?
I didn't even realize that.
Well, I tuned in when I heard genitals and then...
Same, man.
Oh, man. It's about the drums, so boys. Insane. Come on.
I just heard genitals buried in the genital area or something like that. I'm like, what?
I was going to say something about the drumming, too, and now I forgot.
All you have is genitals in your mind now, huh?
Yeah, I guess. Carry a Mary, a motherfucking dictionary. I'm swearing up and down. They can spit this shit hilarious. It's time to put these bitches in the obituary column. We wouldn't see eye to eye with a staring problem. Get the shaft like a staring column.
Those fucking, the kicks, the blast beats, and he's not even breaking a sweat, dude.
Was that just a heel-toe technique or something? That was insane.
No, I don't think so. He must have the trigger. He does the heel-toe technique even with the quadruple, so it just makes it insanely fast, you know?
Yo.
But I don't know if he's doing trigger on this one, too. I can't tell, to be honest. Either way is still fucking insane. Would you ever use a kick like that where you could double your hits by just hitting it once?
Yeah, I'd use anything to if I could accomplish a sound that I couldn't get without it, you know.
Yeah,
I'd give it a try.
To me, my mind can't fathom that, because I've played drums for a little bit, and just getting used to doing double kicks without the extra hit was hard enough, right? So just imagining you get a second hit when it goes up. When you try to slow down, that's got to be really difficult. You know what I mean?
That it would. You'd have to like relearn it for sure.
Right? People are giving him shit about like saying, oh, that's cheating and stuff. I'm like, no, that's like just a whole new skill and tool you got to learn.
You still got to learn how to use it. It doesn't make you automatically good.
You're making the technology work for you instead of the other way around, you know?
Exactly.
Yeah.
I'm a monster. I like that.
That's a tight stack.
Oh shit, I just realized he has the, one of the Rattlers on top of the tom to the right of him. That's fucking cool.
That's how he was getting that sound. I was like, yeah, that doesn't look like a snare. That explains it.
Well, yeah, he has a snare on the floor too that he's hitting, but it doesn't have the Rattler on it. And then he has a tom over the other side that has the Rattler on it. Maybe other drummers have done this. I just haven't seen anything like this, so it's fucking cool.
Dang.
Yeah, badass. I like how he mods his kit to like get the certain sounds, you know?
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
That was dope.
Like every part of the song he has written a different drum pattern for, you know, it's nothing gets repetitive.
Check out my very first time ever reacting to him right here. If you don't know who I am, I'm a sound engineer and a musician, and we have songs right here. You should check it out. Let us know what you think. It's like a melodic kind of metal, hard rock kind of mixture going on. See you guys in the next one. See you.